Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Trey, and I want to talk about Kelly Sue DeConnick because she had this interview along with her husband Matt Fraction about the comic book industry and how she laments on being worried for the comic book industry, how sales went down for independents. Sales that used to be like 30,000 is now successful when it used to get people canceled and everything. At some point you just gotta be like, dang. So my thing is hearing the news article, hearing what she had to say, I just want to be like, so you gotta refuse to be stupid. So you got to refuse to be stupid. So Kelly Sue, comic book industry, Matt Fraction, go ahead and take the crow. Go ahead and take the crow. Take the loss. Take the L and stuff like that. Because how many times have people said, hey, this ain't the way you go about selling these books. This ain't the way you do this kind of this nonsense. And it's true. If I don't like your book, I ain't gonna buy it. Your famous words: If you don't like my politics, don't buy my book. Simple. What are you talking about? There's always been politics in comic books. Stan Lee disagrees, but you know, hey, let's lament on that. But I just kind of find it funny. Like, now you finally want to admit that, you know, hey, you worried for the comic book industry. But you created this problem. You guys created this problem. You had opportunity to change. You had opportunity to course correct, and you didn't. So, I mean, what you want me to say? What you want me to say, Kelly? I was right. A lot of people were right. I guess Comicsgate was right. YouTubers were right. The average Joe person was right. And I mean, I don't know what more to lament on, because you guys obviously understand how the comic book industry work. You understand how books work. You understand how, yes, you can write stories for yourself. You can write stories that you want to write. But at the same time, you have to understand the consequences of your actions. This is what I'm talking about, where, you know, let's stop trying to shield, you know, Hollywood or whatever. And then, you know, stating about, like, hey, the comic book industry has been doing as better, it's booming or whatever. She's stating that she doesn't see that. And it's just like, of course not. I mean, it's been, we've been saying this for a long time that, hey, it doesn't, hey, the comic book industry is failing. It's failing right now. And nobody wanted to listen. Anytime anybody said anything, they was crazy. They were the retards. They were in the wrong. They was in the wrong. They didn't know what they were talking about. They were just haters. And look at it. Like, seriously, look at what's happening with the state of the comic book industry right now. We have all of the, we have books that should have been doing well. What, the top five books maybe sell, but other than that, nobody hardly sells. I mean, what more do you need, you know, need from us? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's kind of crazy, like, how, you know, you're talking about the state of comic books. You're saying that, hey, politics has always been in comic books. I'm going to write what I want to write. If you don't like my politics, don't buy my book. Simple as that. And now you're lamenting on, hey, I don't know about this right now. What you mean you don't know about this right now? I mean, people are going to, I mean, you're talking about comic book stores are closing at a rate, but it seems like you're refusing to understand the main problem of the crux. is like, hey, the reason why a lot of these books are failing, the reason why your stuff doesn't sell, is the fault of y'all, the industry itself. I mean, comic book characters were at an all-time high. And what did DC and Marvel decide to do? Let's do all new, all different. Let's replace most of the characters with diverse versions of themselves. Let's reboot our continuity because reasons. And then let's tell the fans, if they don't like it, they're racist and all that nonsense or whatever. You caused this yourself, Kelly, and Matt Fraction, and the rest of the comic book industry. What am I supposed to do? Oh, I'm sorry that you finally woke up. I mean, but seriously, you have to refuse to be goddamn stupid to not understand the crux of everything. You can't, you have to understand the reason why a lot of these books and stuff are failing is because of creators and writers like you guys who go out and say whatever the hell they want to, call the fans all kinds of crazy names. They need Jesus. Some kind of way, the fans are automatically racist if they don't agree with your views or whatever and stuff like that. Your ideas, your left-leaning politics or whatever. I don't even care, to be honest. Politics or not, I really could care less. But you guys thought that you guys were the moral authority to comic books. Like, once you got a little taste of a little bit of semi-fame, y'all thought that y'all can just go in there and rewrite the characters, tell people what about the characters, then go in there and try to change the characters completely up. Like, Kelly, you came into Captain Marvel and completely made her this feminist icon after years of work that Chris Claremont did to fix the character, to make her likable. You was like, hey, let's make her this feminist empowered bitch, to be honest, because that's what she came off as. She came off as a straight up bitch. No matter how much you want to be like, oh, I liked that run. Look, you can like the run. Y'all can like the Captain Marvel run that Kelly Sue started, but it was trash. Carol came off as a bitch. She completely ignored the entire history and setup of Carol Danvers. But yet, I'm supposed to feel sorry about the lament of the state of the comic book industry when people been numerous times saying it. And not even that, it's proven, it shows you that not even people online are saying anything. Normal people are just walking away silently without saying nothing, because what they gonna say? What they gonna say? Because they see how you guys act online, so it ain't no point of me saying anything. It ain't no point of me making a video. That's how a lot of normal people are who do read comic books. They just don't. They just refuse. They just refuse. They might buy a little Funko Pop here or there. They might buy an action figure. They might go to the movies, and that's about it. That's about it. But other than that, they're not buying the books hardly. So, I mean, what you want? What you want? Then you came into Aquaman. Same nonsense with your political feminist ideologue, and you did the same thing, and got Aquaman canceled after 25 years of having a successful solo run, even if it was rebooted. You know what I'm saying? Like 25 years of an Aquaman run, and Kelly Sue came in there and it was just like, oh shit. I don't know what to say. Like, you know, you want a tissue, you want a hug, or whatever and stuff like that, because it's too late to admit that y'all fault. And even in the video when she was talking, you guys still didn't want to admit the fault. Let's just be honest. Call a spade. Own your shit. That's all I'm saying. Own it. Wipe your ass with your own shit. Own it. But don't sit up here and try to pretend like you didn't. you don't really know what's happening or whatever and stuff like that. The comic book, let's see, how many things we done talked about already. Comic book covers, the price done went up on them, price gouge people out. Then you have variant covers, right? Okay, cool. Then they're not accessible. Then you decide to change the characters completely from what they originally are. So even if there's a movie out or whatever, and people who are fans of the characters or whatever love the characters, you guys made it almost damn near impossible to like the characters, because you completely changed them from what they were supposed to be or who they were, just to pull an agenda to tell your kind of story. And again, I'm not saying that you can't tell your kind of story, or you're not allowed to write what you want to write. But when you're writing for an IP that you don't own, I do expect you to write within the character's history, within restrictions. And that's the problem. Nobody wants to give nobody restrictions. Don't nobody want to edit nobody about nothing. And then when fans correct y'all want to get mad. But you can't tell people, if you don't like my politics, don't buy my book. Guess what? It's not even just Kelly Sue that's been saying that. It's a lot of y'all. Then a lot of y'all chain block people and expect them to buy your book. Make that make sense. You're in an industry where you have to please your customers. I don't understand where we're at, society, where we're not supposed to give the fans what the fans want. If majority of the fans say they want sexy Captain Marvel in the famous black leotard, you shut the fuck up and you put her ass in the damn costume. Stop trying to go with the whole, oh, it's sexist because it shows off her thighs and her boobs and all that kind of stuff. And was it selling? Was it selling? Yes or no? Was it selling? It was selling? Okay, shut the fuck up then. That's the stuff I'm talking about. Y'all come in here and y'all want to create problems that wasn't a problem. It was a problem for you guys because you never really cared about these characters to begin with. That's all that is. You never cared about these characters to begin with. And it's okay, but don't sit up there and expect people to change for your wants, your needs. And that's what I'm talking about. Entertainment had to change to accommodate weirdos. People who didn't care about the fandoms or the characters or whatever. They were just there to try to make a quick buck so they can move on to Hollywood. That's what they were trying to do. That's exactly what they were trying to do. And now we're in comic books. We're in this moment where people are just walking away from it. People are done. And you got nobody to blame but yourself with that one. Who else are you going to blame? Comic book stores are closing. Comics, companies are bleeding money. Some of your top talent is moving to Substack, independence, or going to another genre of work because of the nonsense that you guys been doing these past couple of years. Now you want to see me reflect? It's a little too late. It's a little too late. Own your shit. Own your shit and really be like, hey, we really understand that we said some things that upset the fans. We wrote stories that fans were not pleased with, that went against the character. And for that, we're sorry. You know what I'm saying? But no, you can't do that. You gotta find other reasonings why everything done went wrong. So you gonna refuse to be stupid. That's how I see it. You got to refuse to be stupid. But I mean, what you want me to say? What you want me to say? I mean, we've been saying this for a long time. Comics used to run all over manga. You know what I'm saying? Like, around the world, people were buying comics. Now, everybody like, screw it. We're going to Japan. We're going to manga. Don't you find that funny? It can't just be America that got problems with what y'all doing. It can't be incels, homophobes, and all that kind of nonsense. All of these people, these are people from around the world that had issues with y'all as well. And they let it be known. They let it be known, and they decided not to buy your books. Who is at fault from that? Nobody can give me an answer? No? Because you're looking at the answer. It's you guys. You were at fault. You're the one who screwed up. I mean, to be honest, you guys were the comics gators, to be honest. And I know what people saying, like, what I'm talking about. What I mean is, they was the ones who came into an industry and started to gatekeep and say what was wrong with the characters, what was wrong with the culture itself, what needed to be changed for reasonings to appeal to people. When comics were doing fine. Sure, they had their ups and downs, but they were doing fine. They were still selling. Most people around the world loved them. Now they don't care about them. They don't care about them. When 30,000 is a success, when normally that would have been a cancellation back in the day, you know you fucked up. You know you fucked up. And it's okay. But, you know, it's about time to really put some blame on yourselves, because you guys were the ones who started this from the get-go. You got no one else to blame. I mean, cry me a river at this point. Boo-hoo, life sucks. I mean, it just kind of sucks. Yeah, of course it sucks. Of course it's hurtful. Of course nobody wants to go through, you know, seeing this, but it's the truth. Comic book industry has been in decline for a long time, and people been trying to say, hey, course correct, and you still won't course correct. So, I mean, I don't know what to tell you, Kelly. I don't know what to tell you, comic book industry. I don't know what to tell you, Matt Fraction. I don't know what to tell you. I just kind of find it funny that you guys refuse to be stupid. That's all I'm saying. Make it make sense, please. Make it make sense. You know? Own your shit. That's all I'm saying. Own it. You shitted it out, lay in it, own it. That's how I feel, own it. But maybe next time, you know, you'll keep your mouth closed. Like, karma is a bitch. You know, no matter how much you don't want it to happen, sometimes this is what happens when you're a bitch. This is what happens when you get to tell customers to kiss your ass. They showed you, didn't they? But yeah, those are my thoughts. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section below, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.